Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing the Giver One Giver Quartet book by Lois Lowry. He is trained by the Giver, a man who holds the secrets, history, and the keys to what life was and could be like again. Lowry takes you on a gripping story that makes you question the idea of rebellion, authority, humanity, morality, and life itself. One that tends to the human spirit and intellect with a sophisticated approach to society and the individual. Lois Lowry is absolutely one of those writers of simple genius, a seemingly effortless genius. All events in the book matter, and every page is significant to the transformation of the story. Even the heights of human existence, human achievement, freedom, music, color, and the power of love. The reason being that no one, supposedly, wants to experience the whole range of human emotion. People bring to it their own complicated sense of beliefs, and hopes, and dreams, and fears, and all of that. The book came in paperback form, and was of really good condition when it arrived. There was little exploration of secondary characters, there was so much opportunity to create real, and tangible characters in Jonah's parents, and friends, but it is missed. It seems to be no ending, rather, the author lets the reader decide if Jonas makes it, or not. The Giver's premise is revealed in a way that makes you walk in Jonas' shoes. While the more modern dystopias sometimes skimp on explanation, the world in The Giver is very fully imagined, and therefore, seems more plausible. This might be a turnoff for those who need an adrenaline rush while reading lest they grow bored, but the story is compelling on its own by making readers ask the question, what is going on here? And encouraging them to turn the next page for answers. There is no love, hate, anger, or depression, and hunger and disease have been eradicated. Husband and wives are assigned to each other based upon personality and intelligence as well as your life's occupation. Only one family is different in the community, and that is the Receiver Giver family, who are identified by their light blue eyes. The Giver is a different variety of dystopian fiction, not action-packed and full of violence like much of the current crop. There'll be a tendency to label this ya only, or even middle grade, because the main character is 12. Lowry has created a future that exists just outside the realm of possibility with its edge of magic, but also sits firmly in possibility with its ideals, operations, and view of sameness that permeates the book. Her writing is fresh, flows well, and carries the reader along at an amazing pace that builds tension well, and guides the reader at the same time. Note, there are some scenes in the book that are difficult, but necessary in the revelations of the society and its rules. As with any story, growing used to the jargon and understanding why characters behave the way they do is often a challenge. Other characters that stood out in particular were Asher, his best friend, Jonah's father, and, of course, the Giver. But maybe that was the point: it couldn't change, so the only way out was to escape and hope something better existed out there. But that's the beauty in books. Everyone gets something different out of the same thing. It is a book that helps you appreciate all you have in life, and makes you think about the world, and how you see it. She's a voracious reader, and wanted to add this book to her collection of hardbacks. It's wonderful knowing that, in this day of electronic entertainments, there are children who prefer to read books, versus spending hours playing video games. Wow. The book is set in a very evolved world where every aspect of life is controlled and regulated. Everyone has work, selected for them by the governing council, and there is no hunger and no poverty. The story is told through the eyes of a young boy, 11 going on 12, which is the age when career assignments are given, and they move from children to adults in training. At 12, the twins seem to be getting the implications of the book, so much so that one of the twins was totally upset by it. It's the one area in publishing where there is never a glut of material in the slush pile. The community in which our central character has grown up in is much like what Karl Marx envisioned in the Communist Manifesto. Lowry calls it sameness, not equality, and like real communism, regardless of what appears on paper, it's an impossible dream. With the community where Jonas lives with his family unit, it's about the lack of extreme feelings. In order to eliminate the pain and sadness, they had to eliminate exuberance and love. So much literature, both adult and children, tries to teach this lesson, from Frost's The Road Not Taken to Camus' The Stranger. Some may call it science fiction after all. The first half of the book is reminiscent of the planet on which it lives in Madeleine L'Enclos' A Wrinkle in Time, except the control is more subtle. This book is taught in many middle schools, having pushed Huckleberry Finn, and the lottery aside, these both allude to the concept of death despite being celebrated and never labeled as such, much like the Ministry of Love in 1984 is a site of torture despite its harmless name. Overall, this book offers many questions and keeps you wanting more as a reader throughout the entire story, and it continues to satisfy that need. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.